What up, y'all? This is your boy Lucha Guy, and I'm back with another video. This week, I'm gonna talk a little bit different about the show. But first, hit like and subscribe, please. I need way more subscribers. I don't know why I'm stuck at the same subscriber amount. So, yeah, hit like and subscribe if you're new. If you're an MLW fan, or if you're lost, if you want to know more about Lucha Underground, yeah, hit like and subscribe. And Monster Lucha Slam, the like and subscribe button. But this is about episode 3 of MLW Fusion Alpha. I'm being real, people. I thought this show was kind of weak because it's only a four-week mini-series. And that means next week is the finale. This is what they came with. I mean, the matches was good. Now, I'm not going to say the matches suck. This is the first week. I think the main event was the main event. Jacob Fatu. And by the way, you guys let me know down below, is he related to the rest of the Samoans? Because I believe that last name, is that like the Usos last name? Is he some kin to the Rocks people? You know, he has a little, like he reminds me of those, the tribal stuff, his entrance and all that. I mean, is this Umaga's son or something? Like, I think he's some kin to them. I know he's some kin to the Rocks family. I just want to know whose son is he. Is he Umaga's son? Is he related to Umaga's brother? Is that Umaga's brother's son? Like, what about his relations is with the Usos? But him and Sons of Havoc here, actually, this is the first time I think the main event was actually the main event. I just wish only thing would, This Matt Cross is, wish they give him a new mask. He don't have to wear the black Sons of Havoc mask. He don't have to be a motorcycle guy. They could give him a more vibrant color, a more lighter color. It could be a red mask. It could even be some blue, green, turquoise mask. It could even be a purple mask. But I wish they would let it a little bit more obvious to who he is. Yeah, the main event was actually good, but I noticed they put Azteca Underground under the bus. They kept on hyping up this Fightland show. That seems like more what this show was doing, advertising Fightland and not even Azteca Underground. I just want to ask y'all in the end down below, is this doing a good job hyping up Azteca Underground? Like, are y'all still hyped for it at the same level of Azteca Underground that y'all once were? Because me, it's kind of like, I'm hyped for this for my channel, but as far as my own excitement level, I really don't know. Let me see, let me go back. And on the opening match, the LAX, by the way, y'all feeling this LAX reboot, this, what they call 5150? Are y'all feeling this new LAX that Conan put together, these guys right here? I mean, I thought these guys did a good match. Injustice, I mean, I love their intro. I love that somebody made an Eminem, Dr. Dre, the Conscious song. I just think Injustice needs a little bit more work. But I do like this new LAX. I mean, I'm just want to know how y'all feel about the new LAX 5150. And then the women's match, this was actually good too, because some of the reasons everybody can't do women's wrestling that good. Like, as much as I watched TNA 10 years ago and around that time frame, I could never get into a singles knockouts match. They just had some of the most boring. So Gail Kim is fine, but I could never get into TNA's knockout matches for some reason. But this match here was really good. I did used to watch WOW, all women's promotion. Speaking of which, I was going to actually talk about this separate, but right now I'm going to talk about MLW Fusion. I was going to mention how AJ Lee is now back in wrestling. She's over there in WOW. If you guys know some information about that, you guys can talk about that. Let me know about that down below. But yeah, this is what about it with the show though. The main event was a good match. Jacob Fatu versus Matt Cross / Sons of Havoc. Another complaint I do have about the show, there was no Cesar Dorn. There was no Dario. I do have that complaint. Like, how did they leave off Dario? Like, how the heck did they leave off Dario or Cesar Dorn? And then they didn't even advertise nothing for next week. And that's supposed to be the finale of all this. They're too busy worried about Fightland. Like, next week is going to be the final week of this MLW Fusion Alpha. There was nothing about Azteca Underground. There was nothing said about... So they mentioned Cesar Dorn a lot through the matches, but we didn't see him. It's just strange. And next week's the last week, so whatever they're going to do then, and that's it. Because after that, it's just Azteca Underground that'll be coming up soon. And then MLW Fusion next season should be on the way. But yeah, let me know down below, are y'all, is this MLW Fusion Alpha, all right? Is MLW Fusion Alpha, is this getting y'all more hyped going into Azteca Underground? Let me know down below. Peace. Hit like and subscribe.